या कवितेचं शीर्षक आहे मुंबई। पटकून खांद्यावर टाकून सह्याद्री घाट उतरून माझा बाप तुझ्या दारावर उभा राहिला श्रम घेऊन।
जसा सात रस्ता, डिलाय रोड, सैतान चौकी, लालबाग, शिवडी, परेल, भायखला, जहाँ गिरन के ज्यादा मजदूर है उसको ही गिरन गांव बोला जाता है।
Mumbai's latest fancy and Phoenix Mills has its share.
Many of us appreciate the subtleties of a fine beer.
Because of the vision of the mall developer.
We come and chill out. Advertising and creative professionals, banking professionals.
Always like this, sitting unnoticed in a corner of the city, clustered with others of my own kind. Oh no, things were quite different when I first came to Bombay. I was doing my annual Devi check. You know how we gods get disguised and then walk around, testing to see who will show genuine humanity. It was pretty standard stuff. But then, I came to a city by the sea, and someone took me in.
If you will come to me, I'm hungry. In 10 minutes, I will give you food. I have given food to you, that is important. Sundays, I make fish, paplate, prawns, then surmai, lobster. But lobster is very costly.
So that was my first meal in Bombay City, mandali curry and rice. It was so good, I decided to stay here forever. I blessed the city and I said, as long as I stay, the people here will never go hungry. Well, you can't keep a thing like that secret for long. Soon, people were flocking here from everywhere. And they were eating. Oh, they ate and they ate. There were new restaurants opening every day. And who do you think was in demand? It was me, Annapurna, goddess of food. It was such a wonderful time. All of us happy together. Puts me in a trance just thinking about it.
I love Bombay.
Why do you love Bombay?
To love somebody, I think you don't require a reason. I'm part of Bombay.
Bombay, anyone comes, immediately the person is accepted. We never feel that he's an outsider. You feel that he's from Bombay. And that Bombay's culture is great quality because of which Bombay has prospered.
Really, things were going quite well. And then, she came along.
That's the problem with Annapurna. I shouldn't be talking about my own sister like this, but she was always the jealous kind. You know, full of that sibling rivalry. She says, live and let live. But really, she wants everybody to be like her. But yeah, I don't like going out at night, mixing around with strangers, being the party girl. It's okay, na? I'm happy like this. Anyway. You tell me, can you make a house out of onions and cucumbers and fish and whatnot? No, na. To lead a decent life, you require me, Lakshmi, goddess of wealth.
Om Rim Shri Lakshmi Bhyo Namah.
See, earlier we had a Saraswat Brahmin neighbor, so we had no problem. But when this neighbor came, then one day when that fishwala came, the wife came outside and she told him not to come over here. So I said that last so many years, fish walas are coming over here. I am going to call him and he will come over here. Whether I take fish or I don't take, but he is going to come here. That is a point of principle and I am not going to listen to you.
I have never tasted any non-vegetarian food except eggs sometime prior to 1965. All the people are in my building are vegetarian. If one person comes, a non-vegetarian, and spoils a thing, people may not like it. There are communities, we said this is for a particular community, that is illegal. But if they say it vegetarian, non-vegetarian, it's a question of one's food habit. It is not a question of legality or illegality.
According to them, if you eat non-veg, you may become violent. But you cannot actually call fish as living being. See, living being means living and non-living difference. As per science, is plants are also living things. So you should not eat plants also. You can have only air. See, it is uncomfortable for him, but it's a matter of my food. Why do we live? We should eat what we like, isn't it?
There are 4 blocks that side, 10 floors, so 40 that side, and 3 this side, so 30 this side, 70 in all.
And how many non-vegetarians?
None. You see, because if there are more non-vegetarians coming here, then you'll have shops selling those kind of food, and then that whole atmosphere becomes not so acceptable. Not lack of acceptance to what somebody else does, but again and again I'm telling you that the smells are very strong and the beliefs are very strong. And when a person doesn't feel the need to change the beliefs, why would he want a non-vegetarian to come here?
How is it that the community that lives here has been able to influence not only the buildings, but you know, even the restaurants from end to end, like from Nepean Road to Chowpatty?
There are a lot of Palan Puri Jains here who are diamond merchants, and so they have amassed a lot of wealth. Wealth brings clout. That's why they can control certain things, and our beliefs are very strong. So they live by those beliefs and they have the means to execute them.
It's all very well being the goddess of food and all that, but how much she eats? It's not good for her.
Don't tell her that.
She'll feel bad. As it is, she's depressed because she has to spend time in the office.
I don't get it. I give openly. I hold nothing back. I mean, I tell the people of the city, you will never go hungry. And what do? Either they're dieting or they're fighting. And I'm stuck in the back of this dingy office, dealing with their conflicts all the time. No wonder I don't get promoted. I mean, what's a goddess if people don't sing her glory?
Lakshmi madam ne bheja.
Get out.
I'm Om. I'm a DJ. I've been staying here for last 17 years. There was a roti restaurant over here. Some item for non-veg, some item for veg, but these Jain people protested against the non-veg. It was not a good thing because only in this Mathurashi is the Jain things stay. Mostly in Nepean Sea Road, many Mohammedans and all that, they like to eat non-veg. I too eat non-veg sometimes. So I feel a little depressed that they just closed.
Created pickets outside our restaurant, you know, made life miserable for the customers who came there, put up hoardings everywhere, people in the building threw stuff on people coming down, we got police protection, everything and all. And ultimately they didn't stop us, we chose to stop because it became such a big ordeal to continue doing business there that it just wasn't worth the effort. They were hell-bent on closing it down.
If I get another place where I can eat comfortably, I don't mind. There are people who come to our house, they are everybody, they are Bengalis, they are Muslims, we have friends. But living together is another matter.
She always does this. I go to a place, I build it up from scratch, I make it wonderful, everybody is happy. And then she wants to come along and get a piece of the action and she wants to change all the rules. Who came here first, I would like to ask you? Who?
She said that, huh? So low class to blow one's own trumpet like that. Actually, people don't like others' success. They always try to pull you down. Thing is, she's really only a minor goddess. She's got such delusions of grandeur and all those gaudy saris. Her basic problem is no respect for tradition.
Nowadays, I don't talk to him because I cannot stoop to that level and go on quarreling like a uneducated lady. So I don't talk to him. I have told him don't talk to me in any matters. It's better that you are my neighbor, you stay there quietly, I will stay here quietly.
Do you think you live in a ghetto?
If you want to put it that way, I feel very comfortable. You should ask a Muslim what he feels if he has to live where there are non-Muslims.
But people won't rent to Muslims in Bombay.
So ask a Punjabi then.
ये रियल में आंदोलन है, मतलब जो बंगाल देश से आए हुए हैं धोती पर लुंगी पहन के मच्छी बेचते हैं उसके ऊपर से
यूपी के भैये आंध्र प्रदेश के आए ले बिहार के आए ले उनके विरोध है।
समुद्र के अंदर भी मच्छी नहीं है,
क्यों नहीं है मच्छी?
अभी क्या मालूम है, कोली लोगों को जो सहूलत दी थी वो भी सहूलत छीन ली है, अभी कोली लोग क्या करेंगे? इसलिए हम लोग को भैया नहीं मांगता है, उसने कुछ भी धंधा करना दो, उसने कुछ भी धंधा लेकिन मच्छी का धंधा नहीं करना है, उनको दूसरा धंधा करने दो ना।
दूसरा धंधा करो, वो चला रहे हैं,
मतलब ऐसा नहीं बोलते कि भैया कंप्लीट से हटा बंबई से, ऐसा नहीं बोलते।
सी, इट्स नॉट अ जोक बीइंग अ गॉडेस, एंड वन ऑफ द गोल्डन रूल्स इज डोंट गेट अटैच्ड, बेटर टू शो अ लिटिल रिस्ट्रेन एंड नॉट मिक्स इट अप टू मच। आई मीन यू कैन गिव अ ब्लेसिंग बट यू डोंट नो व्हाट द पीपल विल डू विद इट, डू यू?
वेल आई ट्राइड टू मेक द वर्ल्ड अ बिट बेटर। Before it breaks my heart, I think I'll put my ladle down and go someplace where I don't make so many waves.